move forward, it's 10-2. Clerk is next.
Okay, I'll make it real quick. Quiz seems slowed down.
I suspect they'll pick up.
Yeah, major prediction. I do have a couple of commercial quiz that I'm working on, nothing in the range. So that's a good thing. First, the newsletter, I was directed by Chris Forman.
We're going to delay that till the second week in November.
In November, you said?
But it is pretty much put together based on our regulations. We're trying to get it done in the next morning. No, what she's saying. Yeah, we're working on that. And the other thing I'm working with is Big Cut and Lake County and Hilton. We're doing another water testing event. Water test kits. It'll be available to the residents November 7th. I believe it might already be on our website. I'm not sure. I don't know if it warrants a CTY.
No, no, CTY, how many samples do you have?
We have about 20, but we just got them this afternoon. What was it? So I can forward more information about that.
Keep one for me, because I'm...
In addition to that, I think Bob, you mentioned that I'm working on our council. Anybody has any questions?
Trustee Denny, you want the investments of the report approved?
Yes. Page 203, 204, detail of accounts payable in the amount of just over $187,000. Page 204 is payroll in the amount of $22,800. So I'd like to make a motion to approve expenditures totaling $210,151.23. Do I have a second?
I second.
Okay, roll call.
I have a question. Did we get to go over that last one?
He's going to do both at one time. He doesn't realize it. He did both at one time.
Okay. And on page 173, I'd like approval for, I'd also like to add approval for the investment settlement report as of September 30th in the amount of $1,518,618.77.
Roll call, please.
Okay.
I did.
Jordan.
Denny?
Yes.
Olson?
Yes.
Denny?
Yes.
Zernick?
Yes.
Thompson?
Yes.
That concludes where we are.
I know.
question, you're planning stage and then bring that up. Right now, I think DDR would be enough. The problem you got right now, DDR is doing a lot of things with the university, I don't think she realizes that. Because the other question we got is, they're gonna have that Santa Claus coming, do you remember the month or something? What do they do, did you advise them that they have their 4-month police officers? And they have a fire department there. They have a fire department with fireworks.
Are they doing fireworks this year?
They do it every year. Well, they have to have fireworks, and normally Santa Claus comes in on fire. That's another, that, you know what I'm saying? And then normally there's 4 or 5 police officers, I don't think this, does she know what she's doing?
Yes, I do, I think she's very confused, you're telling me last year that's all the things that they require.
Well, they required that for the last 2 years. Because they shoot the fireworks right off on, I don't know whether they aim them, but they might aim them at those cameras.
All the junk.
No, I'm serious, I'm not pointing at them.
Right.
They aim them at the condos because that's the way, when they have to check the wind, they're very conscientious on this.
Well, I would think, like when all the towns had fireworks shows, like the 4th of July, they had the fire department involved, I think that'd be standard.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, that would.
Has to sign off on the any fireworks permit as does the village.
Right, so that would make sense, and as far as, did you get a big crowd?
Now, on that, you brought the point, they have the permit from the village too, they have the permit from the village for the fireworks.
I'm sure they've done it before, right?
I just know what I asked. You're saying this lady's on the wall, does she have the permit from the village to do the fireworks, if they're doing fireworks? I'll give you odds, she doesn't.
She does.
She's making, doing a good job.
Has she contacted you about this?
I have no idea.
I think Jim Connors would probably know if she contacted the office.
I don't know about this year, but years past, they've always gotten a special permit.
Okay.
Especially the permit, yes.
And then for the group, we're working on the brochure. The previous brochure had a lot of things in there that were not through the contract, so we straightened that out and did a lot of back and forth. And now that the only thing I was waiting for was the approval of the new hire, so we add that to that, and that should be able to go out to printers and we can send that out at their expense. And then I got the call today about the Panera grand opening on Saturday. They got my number, they want to know if I was gonna be there, and I know that Alan mentioned this earlier, but someone else is gonna be there for the grand opening.
They had called me, I was gonna bring, that's why I brought up the meeting. I think we should have someone there. Myself, I haven't had a weekend off, I might take a weekend off.
Sure.
If you could attend, or if any of the trustees want to attend that weekend off.
Yeah, I hope to attend it, I have to just check a couple things to see if I can get there exactly at 9 o'clock. But I was planning to go there by 9:30. And I just wanted to know if anyone else is.
What day is it?
Saturday morning at 9 o'clock.
9 o'clock.
Well, if anyone's able to go, they can let me know.
I'll let you know, I'm kind of like to, I don't have control of the Saturday schedule.
Now, just a pretty one question is, in the past, I've had reports of DDR to do the introduction of Santa Claus or something, the clock or something like that.
Right.
They haven't contacted me or anything on that.
Oh, really?
I really don't think, she's made so many mistakes in the past on these other things that I think that the two processors did them automatically, and the other gentleman doesn't realize it.
So you would have expected to hear from them by now?
Oh, I agree. I would have hoped to.
Okay. Okay, that's all.
Okay. I don't think we have anyone public here. Do we have anyone public here? Good meeting. We accomplished quite a bit today. It's very well, so the meeting, I think it's done under very professional conditions for the circuit. think we got, send the new trustees got caught in the trick bag, the old trustees bringing out, or the old better lawyer routine.
Yeah, since we're still in public forum, I'd like to say that I didn't appreciate that. I don't appreciate, prior trustees, making those kinds of presentations.
What you're saying, Jim, is, and I agree with you, that it's out of poor taste.
Yeah.
But as a resident, they can say whatever they want to.
Absolutely.
And that's absolutely the burden they have to take with it, but I would say that this board conducted themselves on a very professional basis. I think the Kildare Police conducted themselves on a professional basis.
You know, I particularly felt sorry to the officers, they had nothing to do with any of this.
Yep.
And if there's something we can do towards employment or done with Lake County.
I agree with that. And is there something we can, we present?
Is there any recommendation or any?
No, no.
But, I've talked to county administrator, they're eligible to enter into the lateral transfer program. But they have to be acceptable to the sheriff's department.
They have to go through the interview process.
Okay, let me just make one comment, is, let's get out of the, this is full session stuff, we should be going into.
I want to say one, I give kudos to Mr. Bacon, I thought he did an excellent job describing in a very balanced way, the things that went on. I thought he came to officially answer a lot of their questions.
Yes, he did.
I think we handled it very well. Okay, we have a motion to adjourn. We have a new full session for it.
Any further, direction in terms of how I should, respond to, Kildare's special counsel?
Okay, full session, we have a motion on the full session.
I'd like the